Hello, I'm James Preston and welcome to another edition of Executive Corner Expert Talks. Machine learning, AI and blockchain technology are becoming an integral part of the marketing industry. Whilst the connection might not always be apparent, it is helping change the way that businesses engage with consumers. One company who is utilising this new wave of technology to help better understand the market that they cater for is SMS-iT, and to talk us through what the company is doing and the exciting developments in the marketing space, the founder, CEO and CFO of SMS-iT, Henry Skull, joins me live on Kalkine. Henry, great to have you here with us today.
How you doing? I'm pleased to be right here.
Yeah, doing very well. It's fantastic to have your company. Now, Henry, first and foremost, can you take us through exactly what it is that SMS-iT does?
So what we do is to provide an opportunity where customers could reduce churn in their businesses, build new leads, and also, most importantly, engage with their customers using what we call personalized interactions with trusted communications.
And so how exactly do you do that? Is that using mass sort of text campaigns? How does that work?
Well, that works utilizing two arenas. So first, we have what we call an omni-channel messaging platform, okay? And that works by combining SMS, MMS, RCS, chat, email, fax, and voice in one platform. So as a user or as a business, you do not need to go to several other softwares to complete what you want to complete. And then the other section, the other part that we have is our metaverse, and with our metaverse, what we aim to do is to enable customers get what we call the profit lead, where they could cherry pick. All right. So imagine a scenario right now where you come, you sign up on SMSA, you log into the system. Now you can create an avatar, okay? And once you do this, you could actually utilize what we call our interactive direct marketing. And what happens here is that as an advertiser, you're gonna have a dashboard, okay, that is managed by artificial intelligence. And what that dashboard does is to give you what we call a signal or a rating. So once you go into the metaverse to explore the metaverse, and you see other users, but that dashboard is going to let you know if that user is your profit lead or not by giving you a rating. So it's going to probably tell you, oh, 90%, 20%, 60%. And then let's say it's 90% and it's a match. Now you could decide to approach that user and sell or engage. And what's also lovely is that within that system, we have a PPC where 50% of the bid that an advertiser bids for that campaign goes directly to the user that engages with that advertiser, while 50% comes to us. So that gives users incentives to actually engage with advertisers, and gives advertisers the opportunity to actually engage with profit leads, sell, communicate. And during this process, of course, users share their information with advertisers. So advertisers could continue with omni-channel messaging with these users afterwards.
Well, Henry, it does seem to be like marketing at quite literally every level. I mean, you've got the max test campaigns, you've also got the metaverse in there, you've got emails online, so it's pretty much all over the place. When you're talking about that metaverse concept itself, though, is this your own metaverse that you've developed, or is it also able to integrate with things such as the Sandbox and Decentraland, where we've seen, you know, stores for Nike and Adidas living in those realms? Like, is this something where we can get partnerships into other metaverses as well?
Exactly. Right now, we have our API, and our API is configured for integration with other metaverses, from sandbox to Decentraland. And then we coming up with our metaverse where folks could actually have inbuilt features and have marketing on another level. And what's also super important is that SMS is a platform built originally, okay, for omni-channel messaging and integration into other metaverses, including our metaverse.
Well, I mean, another thing that you've been delving into within this space, obviously blockchain technology has many different implications and mechanisms that can be used for it, whether it be the metaverse or more simple sort of crypto stuff. But one thing you've recently done is creation of NFTs, and that is ultimately to do with assisting and supporting Ukrainian refugees. How exactly is that working? How have you done that?
Well, the reason why we created the NFT was simply to help out Ukrainian refugees with the current crisis they're facing. And we were trying to utilize actions and not words. So we went ahead and built out that NFT where the idea is to actually help these folks out with the welfare conditions, try helping them out with the current standard of living. Raising funds through our NFT launch, we believe, would help achieve this goal. And if the public wanna participate in this humanitarian effort, they can always visit our OpenSea page and purchase the NFT. What we do directly is proceed of these NFTs, proceeds would be paid directly to wallets owned by organizations that are directly involved in helping out the refugee crisis in Ukraine.
Yeah, look, it's one of the worst geopolitical disasters we've had in probably 30 or 40 years. So it's fantastic you guys getting on board and trying to help out where you can. Now, you also recently announced that SMS-iT is now officially backed by TDFi, which now gives you access to the TDFi Accelerator Program and, well, the entire TDFi ecosystem of startups for different strategic partnerships and integrations. Can you take us through the key advantages of having that partnership now come into effect?
Well, that's a lovely question. TDFi gives a lot of advantages, and first advantage that we're experiencing right now is advisory. So when it comes to having a company fully prepared for investors, for consumers, for the marketplace, TDFi actually does a very good job. And with TDFi, we would proceed also with our tokenization goal, fundraising, launching of our blockchain network and protocol, launching of our metaverse also, more strategic partnerships, launching of our ecosystem, because the whole idea is bringing omni-channel messaging to the physical and the virtual world. And TDFi has a lot of experience when it comes to the crypto space. And leveraging this is one of the reasons why we are super excited to be on board and incubated by TDFi at this current time.
Well, you mentioned their tokenization, Henry. I wanna ask, how far along the roadmap are you? Is there a clear goal as to when you want to launch this so that the public can get involved and start investing in what you're doing?
That's another lovely question. Yeah, on our roadmap, we started off with having this omni-channel messaging platform built out. And how did we get here? So we all started in 2021, where we started off with a small messaging platform for email marketing, but then we received a lot of complaints from users, complained about spam traps, complained about poor leads, complained about the fact that when you put emails versus SMSs, SMSs has about 95% open rate. Now, that's a fact. And utilizing that fact and utilizing a lot of feedbacks from users, we went ahead and came up with SMS-iT. Now, trying to get the profit lead is kind of difficult in today's world, but it's actually super easy in the metaverse. That's the reason why the metaverse came into play, because what happened first was we created the omni-channel messaging platform with our API and all the beautiful about 51 plus features. It's ready right now. We currently have about 2,000 plus users, and users can connect our omni-channel messaging platform directly to any metaverse right now, even to the blockchain into smart contracts. So that's working already. But then how do we make sure that users can actually get the profit leads easily, especially for folks that do not have leads right now, you know? So the metaverse can bring this possibility to reality very easily, because companies can now interact with users based on the terms of users, and users can also receive rewards while they engage with companies. And that's the whole idea of why we decided to bring the omni-channel messaging into the metaverse, and not just into all metaverses, but also by trying to create our metaverse that would have some features that current metaverses do not have.
Well, it seems like it's next level interoperable. It's not just with other metaverses, it's also in completely other different mediums. I mean, as you mentioned there, whether it be email, text, the 95% opening rate, of course, and then from there, metaverse, yeah, I would imagine you're correct. It's even more effective, given that it's essentially as close as we're going to get right now to doing sort of one-on-one personalized marketing, actually having a conversation. It's just a virtual form of yourself. So I think you're right. That's definitely where things seem to be headed. There's probably also congratulations in order though, Henry, as well, because as I understand, SMS-iT has won the Next Top Ton, startup by Ton Alliance, at the Blockchain Hackathon Awards. Now, take me through that, because that's a pretty great accolade to receive.
Well, we had almost 300 participants, and it was very challenging, where we had to have that project right there win, and the process was actually also very rewarding. And what happened was that now we had access to several ecosystems. Example, after winning that award, we're able to pitch to the TDFI board, and after several pitch rounds, we won again, and then we became incubated. And the experience also made us understand the current thoughts of other entrepreneurs or individuals or creators in the entire blockchain space. We also got to understand how we could serve our users better, how we could look at our innovations and even make it more streamlined, not more futuristic, but more streamlined in such a manner that it actually can meet the needs and wants of our target audiences in very innovative ways.
Henry, we've spoken a lot about blockchain technology, the metaverse and those kind of concepts, but how would you say that artificial intelligence and automation is transforming the marketing business, or just the entire sector for that matter?
Well, I could just summarize that by stating that, one, AI and automation has enabled the process of getting what we call the profit lead by leveraging big data. Okay, and number two, AI and automation can help businesses reduce churn, and these are customers that leave your business. And how is that possible? By automating processes, by automating your workflow, okay? Because the AI can work 24/7 every day. A human cannot work 24/7 every day. And the AI can also get smarter and can look for new cues or new persuasive techniques that are very ethical and engage with customers long-term. AI and automation can also dramatically increase your ROI, because talk about economies of scale and scope right here, right? Where you probably invest months into the algorithm and that's it. It gets better. It's lovely. So these are the points that I wanted to touch on when it comes to that question about whether artificial intelligence and automation bring to today's market.
Now, I know you're very busy at the moment working with the likes of TDFi and trying to get things to that next level, but what would you say would your plans be for the next 12 months and beyond that period of time as well?
Well, another lovely question. Well, on our timeline, what we focused on right now would be number one, our tokenization process. We're in about 1 to 2 months from today, we'll be planning having that token available. And then we would have our new blockchain protocol that's currently in dev ready. After that, our metaverse that we would be launching, that would be integrated with our current omni-channel messaging platform, would also come into play. And after that, we also have several features and several other integrations and partnerships that we have lined up in our roadmap. Now, investors who want to see our pitch deck can easily reach us at invest@smsit.ai. And in our pitch deck, we actually took our time to outline all this in much greater details.
Well, Henry, it's been really great to chat with you today. Just before I let you go, where can we find out more information about what it is that SMS-iT, should I say, is getting up to?
Well, you can reach us at smsit.ai, and you can also find us on the Google Play Store, and also you can also find us on the Apple, on the iOS Store, and we also right there on several social media platforms, from Facebook to LinkedIn, all the way to YouTube. SMSIT.AI should be real. You should start from.
Well, brilliant. It looks like a very exciting couple of months ahead for SMSIT. And Henry, it's been awesome to chat with you today. Best of luck for the future.
Thanks a lot. Have a beautiful day.
Well, that's Henry Scull, the founder, CEO and CFO of SMS-iT. And if you missed any part of that chat, you can catch the full interview on Kalkine Media's YouTube channel, so make sure that you subscribe. I'm James Preston, reminding you to stay apprised and invest wise.